Reverend fathers, reverend sisters, I thank God that I have still a voice to give the keynote address. My voice is not caused by singing operatic songs, but my internal cold acquired a few days ago. I like to situate our team in a broader perspective. First, the dialogue of cultures, also called intercultural dialogue. Intercultural dialogue is complicated because it is burdened by reservations, stereotypes, and historical experiences from which mutual distrust grows. Because of these difficulties, it will be helpful for us to refer to Martin Buber's philosophy of dialogue, wherein he emphasized the importance of readiness to listen, which itself presupposes the ability to remain silent. What is important to keep in mind is that dialogue is a way, that is a process of learning that acquires the willingness to change of all involved. Dialogue of cultures should not be some short-term emergency measure, but a long-term, long-lasting process that must take place not only at the cultural level, but also at the political and economic level. Above all, dialogue must be institutionalized, meaning to say, supported by institutions created just to support it. There are three basic principles in dialogue. If we accept the concept of dialogue as a debate, and this concept is exposed by two persons, Carl Otto Appel and Jordan Habermas. First principle is equality of the parties involved. Second, knowledge and tolerance towards the other culture without cultural relativism. And third, the search for a canon of common values. Two of the movies I have seen in the past are more than less a dialogue of culture. One movie is Dance with the Wolves, John Dunbar, played by actor Kevin Costner, was an intentional hero, and for that he was reassigned where both post in South Dakota, where he encountered the Native American Indian, the Sioux. Attracted by the natural simplicity of their lifestyle, he chooses to leave his former life behind to join them, taking on the name Dances with Wolves. So, he has become a welcome member of the tribe. They came to like each other and understand each other. The other film, a few years ago, is The Last Samurai. The American actor is played by Tom Cruise, and the Japanese actor is played by Ken Watanabe. As a soldier of fortune, he was captured by the Japanese warrior, learned their language, their values, and came to appreciate their way of life. At the end, he sided and fought with them. Do we have to be captured by the so-called enemies in order to appreciate their way of life? Do we have to live near them, to tolerate them, and live peacefully with them? This brings us to the second perspective, the second